When the music fades and all is stripped away, and I simply come longing just to bring something that's of worth, that'll bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You've searched much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the things I've made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. King of endless worth, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, all I have is yours, every single breath. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the things I've made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the things I've made it. When it's all about you, all about you, Jesus.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to worship tonight here at Flame of Faith United Methodist Church. My name is Janson. I am a worship leader here, and I want to say I'm excited. It's like an energetic kind of thing, but I just really feel good about tonight's worship service. I don't know, I don't have the right words for it, and that happens a lot with me. So I'm glad everyone's here. My name is Janson, if I didn't already mention that. I'm a worship leader here. I'm also the administrative assistant, and I'm also a seminary student. If you're interested in this evening's order of worship, you can go to our website, flameoffaithumc.org, and click on the button that says Order of Worship. It takes you to a page that has just a brief, like a sketch of the service, but you can get more information if you click on the PDF file. That's got all the song lyrics, the prayers, the scripture, and nothing extra this week, but maybe next week. I think I put something extra in next week. You'll have to check it out and see to find out what it is. For those here in the sanctuary, there are clipboards in every pew, and if you would, fill out a section of those on one of those. Just to let us know you're here so we can keep you updated, and just so tell us how you're doing. We'd love to hear how you're doing. And there's also a section for prayer requests on there. So if you have anything that you'd like us to join with you, praying for you on there, you can just fill in where the prayer request section is. If you are watching online, for all those of you, welcome. You can check in on there's a link in the description below to check in at the digital sign-in. It's basically the clipboard, but you can do it from home. by clicking on that. Now I'd like to transition us into a time of prayer. I will start with we'll all start with a time of silent prayer. I will continue with the pastoral prayer, and then we'll join together for the Lord's Prayer. The Lord's Prayer, the words that we use are on the screen, and they're also in that PDF file, but please feel free, pray it in whatever tradition that you're used to. It doesn't bother me if there are extra words. We'll all fit in the same amount of space. It'll be just fine. We'll end with amen, and it'll just be great. And again, if you have prayer requests, you can write them on the clipboard. You can use them. There's a section in the online check-in. You can write it on there. You can email us. You can call us. If you're comfortable, after this is streamed live, you can leave any message to us in the comments of the video. All right, let us pray. Lord, you called us to this journey. We aren't very willing to let go of the things that bind us, even those which harm our spirits and diminish our souls. We cling to our problems as though they provide some degree of comfort and stability. Help us to let go of the pain, the problems, the chains that bind our souls, even our hearts, to hear your word. Place us on the journey with confidence and assurance of your presence. As we've offered the names and situations of those near and dear to us tonight in our silent prayers, help us to remember that we too are always in your loving care. When we have fallen, lift us up, Lord. When we think that we can go no further, pick us up and carry us until we can walk again. When we wonder if you made the right choice in calling us to our ministry and mission, ease our fears, confirm our hopes, bless our hearts with your loving presence, that in all things you may be glorified. We pray this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us to pray together as one people, saying, Our God in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today your daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And as we lift up our prayers and those we're praying for, we also have this opportunity tonight to give of ourselves. We give our time, our gifts, our talents, our tithes, and our offerings. For those who are physically in the sanctuary, we have offering plates by either door. You can use our website, flameoffaithumc.org/donate. You can use the Vanco mobile app, just search for Flame of Faith United Methodist Church. Or you can always mail a paper check to the church building. The address is on the screen. Join me in a prayer of thanksgiving over tonight's offering. God of all goodness and grace, receive the gifts we offer and grant that our lives may give you glory and praise. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The cry of my heart to follow you. It is the cry of my heart to be close to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow all of the days of my life. It is the cry of my heart to follow you. It is the cry of my heart to be close to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow all of the days of my life. me your holy ways, O Lord, and make me wholly devoted to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow you. It is the cry of my heart to be close to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow all of the days of my life. Open my eyes so I can see the wonderful things that you do. Open my heart up more and more and make it wholly devoted to you. It is the cry of my heart to be close to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow all of the days of my life. It is the cry of my heart to follow you. It is the cry of my heart to be close to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow all of the days of my life. All of the days of my life, all of the days of my life.
Good evening again. I am Pastor Sara. Oh, you set this up for you. I'm not that tall. I'm Pastor Sara McManus, and it is a joy to worship together here in this space and across our time together. Thank you to Billy and Janson for getting us started with music and prayer. We have a couple of announcements to start us off. Our soul building continues tonight as we talk about guidance and what that discipline is in our life. Our soul, or our Lent event, will be quite a bit of fun tonight. We're doing a scavenger hunt, I think. So that'll be a lot of fun. The Sunday group is nodding their head. Yes, that is what we did on Sunday. Our weekly walking will happen tomorrow at 10 a.m. at the Rusted Center. So if you are interested in joining in, let me know. We'll be there, and we will walk as best we can. Our devotions continue on Facebook. We had a really funny, those who were a part of Monday night's book study, it was on Tuesday morning, the devotion happened to be very similar to the discussion we had on Monday night, talking about forgiveness and even those older things that we have that we kind of hold on to as we know we hurt somebody even in time past, and how to work through that and confessing in those ways. We're going to talk more about confession in a couple weeks. Our camps are, we've got our camps going, and our all of the schedule is out. If you are interested in heading to camp this summer and want to get signed up, please use the code FLAMECAMPERS. It's a scholarship here for the kids here at Flame of Faith. We have begun our equipment donation. We've got what all do we have? We have a shower chair and a walker. We've got a couple things already brought in. So if you are doing spring cleaning, that I think is why they're focused on this, spring cleaning cleanup, and you've got some old medical devices or supplies that you think can be recycled, bring them on over, and Hero will clean them up, get them ready, and send them out to be used again. June 19th through 23rd, we have our Impact Fargo, which is a mission trip for any youth, 7th through 12th grade. This is, we will be gathered with youth groups across the Fargo-Moorhead area, as well as youth from other churches. And so it's going to be a lot of fun. We've got already, we're working with HERO, the Great Plains Food Bank, working with the Autism Center, working with a couple different places already, and those are just the organizations we've connected with. And so I'm excited for it. Any youth who want to participate, let me know. We'll kind of sign up as a group. And then also, any adults that would like to be chaperones, please let me know. I'm getting nods of no. To those of you at home, I was corrected. This is a shake. This is a nod. I learn things sometimes. Other announcement, for those who are here in the sanctuary especially, we've got our worship bag supplies a whole lot more organized than we had last week. Grab a bag, fill it up with what you need, bring it on in. We have adult coloring stuff, we have fidgets, we have wiggle seats, we have lap pads and blankets. I hadn't realized how much I would use a fidget until I grabbed one to use as a prop and then spent the entire time playing with it. So it turns out adults fidget as much as anyone else in our lives. All right, now I invite our own Janson Steffan to come forward to guide us. It's guidance. I'm so funny. No, not really. He's going to lead us in our scripture tonight.
I printed it real big so I can read it.
Awesome. Good evening, everybody. Again, I already said my name is Janson. Tonight's scripture is from the book of Luke, chapter 24, verses 13 through 35. Now on that same day, two of them were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all these things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing, Jesus himself came near and went with them, but their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And he said to them, "What are you discussing with each other while you walk along?" They stood still, looking sad. Then one of them, whose name was Cleopas, answered him, "Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have taken place there in these days?" He asked them, "What things?" They replied, "The things about Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all this, it is now the third day since these things took place. Moreover, some women of our group astounded us. They were at the tomb early this morning, and when they did not find his body there, they came back and told us that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see him. Then he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have declared. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and then enter into his glory?' Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them the things about himself in all the scriptures. As they came near the village to which they were going, he walked ahead as if he were going on. But they urged him strongly, saying, 'Stay with us, because it is almost evening and the day is now nearly over.' So he went in to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and he vanished from their sight. They said to each other, 'Were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road, while he was opening the scriptures to us?' That same hour they got up and returned to Jerusalem, and they found the 11 and their companions gathered together. They were saying, 'The Lord has risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon.' Then they told what had happened on the road, and how he had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread." Here ends tonight's reading. My son and I used to make a yearly trek to Valley Fair in Shakopee, Minnesota. I don't know if you've been there before, but it is awesome. And no, I'm not being paid for a promotion. There's no asterisk in our video, anything like that. It's just really fun. They have a lot of great food, and by great, I mean fattening and not good for you. They have all sorts of entertainment events where they put on like little shows and concerts. They have at least, I think they have one or two different video game arcades. They have a huge water park with a nice big lazy river to go around in. And then they have plenty of rides to go on. Does anybody here like rides? There's a few, awesome. What kind of rides do you like? Pony rides? The ones that just go around and around in a circle? Well, there'll be time. There's time. Valley Fair is awesome, and it feels like it's always there. And they're always adding on more stuff to it and fixing things that are rickety and old. Do you like roller coasters? Do you like... Oh, I swear there's one at every service. There was one on Sunday. Yep. I really like roller coasters. I think I love that feeling of going... When you go down really fast and you just feel like everything lift for a minute, it's like terrifying and amazing all in the same moment. This is one called the Wild Thing, and I've ridden it probably at least a million times. I went there once early in the morning, and there weren't a lot of people there, so we could just ride it and go back down and get right back in the beginning of the line, and the next time it came around, we must have done that for like an hour, and it only takes 3.5 minutes. I just want us to watch. I didn't put the sound in there because I can't stand that noise as you're going up. It's like, I don't know, it's almost unnerving. Yeah, anticipation prepares you for the top. And being in the front is not the best position because it's waiting, it's hanging you over the edge while the back gets up there, and then it goes down. I like to be 2/3 of the way back. Oh, are you all right? Okay. Roller coaster enthusiasts are sometimes referred to as thrill seekers. At the center of their soul is a passion for the excitement of great heights and rocketing speeds. Modern roller coasters are essentially these loose cars with guides to keep them on the rails. It's like a two-rail system. There are the top wheels that are the load wheel. It's like the car is just sitting on the rail. There's the bottom wheel that's called the upstop wheel. That's so if you go over something, the car doesn't lift off the track. But the ones that keep everything going straight, that keep you from moving left to right, are the guide wheels. Our lives sometimes feel like this roller coaster. We go from this moment of elation to another moment of terror, and then sometimes we hit that really nice straightaway where it's just really relaxing just for a little bit. And we feel grateful that educated engineers have done the work to create the wheels guide systems to keep the cars on the tracks. In examples like this, the guides that keep the cars on the rails are like the teachers and mentors that keep students on the right path. So in our own studies as Christians, what are our tools? The Bible. The Bible is our tool. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. Hopefully we'll do that song, Amy Grant, again soon. Every time I read that, all I can think of is Amy Grant. Many people who simply read the Bible from cover to cover, they say it's too difficult, it's too confusing. Why is this God in the Old Testament so full of anger and wrath, yet in the New Testament it's all loving? And there's so many questions about the book of Revelation. No matter how many times we study it, it seems there are always more questions. Dr. Rashad Ritchie is an Emmy-nominated broadcaster. He's a political strategist, a news analyst, a business executive, university professor, lecturer, entrepreneur, and advocate. He's also studying for the bar exam. He's amazing. He talks about faith and the Bible in this way. He said, "God gave me a brain before he gave me a book." So to fully understand all the Bible has to offer, we must be willing to ask questions. We need clarity. We need to have disagreements and arguments. Just look at how many translations we already have. And for each of those, we have numerous commentaries by scholars and theologians analyzing these ancient documents. So we read the Bible translation of our choosing. We read a really solid modern commentary. And so what? So what? A component of study that is too often ignored is the time of reflection. What does this mean for me in my life? Where do I go? What do I do now? Well, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. We often think about Jesus Christ as a healer. Christ is kind of like a therapist. A therapist listens and hears you cry out in pain or shout for joy. And a therapist gives you the tools. You still have to do the work. Which brings me to our second tool, each other. The Holy Spirit works through people. We see it happen every day, and too often we just brush it off as it's just a coincidence. And later we start connecting all these dots, and we realize how God has been working in our lives all along through both happiness and hardship, from joyful celebrations and sacred ceremonies to immense suffering and imposed solitude, teaching us as we go. Looking at today's scripture lesson, Jesus approaches these two men and then starts explaining everything that had happened since the time of Moses. The students are guided by the Master, the capital M, Master. You might notice that all tonight's songs have the word heart in their title. I believe that this is where guidance can impact us. It's in those God moments that we can see more clearly the true path to follow. We can really feel the presence of God. And what greater moment than to look at a travel companion and realize that it was Jesus? Guidance and study are intertwined. Here at Flame of Faith, we have Christian discipleship training for kids and adults. We regularly hold Bible studies, both in person and online. We have book studies and discussion groups. These times dedicated to study create moments for guidance. So this isn't necessarily always the way it happens, but it's one way it can happen. We are recipients of guidance from God and Jesus Christ through the power of the Holy Spirit. And that then encourages, and we're kind of almost drawn to study, which moves to time of personal and spiritual reflection, which then goes to growth in faith. But I feel like it always leads to gratitude. Ever since I came here about 5 years ago, we've been talking about telling our own stories to help us and others grow in their faith. For a while, Pastor Sara and I were filming interviews with people, different members of the congregation. I still have an unseen interview with Carol Knodel that maybe eventually one of these days will see the light of day. We also had that six-week sermon series where people from this congregation told their stories. Speaking from experience and incorporating gratitude as a component woven into study and guidance, I want to tell you how God's guidance has shaped my story, my testimony. This is a timeline. It's like a map showing what I believe to be clear evidence of God's direction in my life. This is also my way of honoring those who've guided me and encouraged me to study. So my parents, my grandparents, my great-grandparents, this was at St. Mark's Lutheran Church in Fargo, where I was baptized, attended Sunday school, and was involved in children's plays, and it really got me connected and interested in music. My mom was the superintendent of Sunday schools. Yeah, so family involvement. Pastor Doug Gunkelman, Pastor Tim Stoa, Steve Revland, Sonia and Milt Myrie at Bethlehem Lutheran Church in Fargo, where I went to Sunday school, sang in the children's choir, played piano and trumpet for worship services, was a member of the handbell choir, received my first communion, and played guitar with the worship band in his name. This would also be the church where I had my son baptized. He's actually wearing the same little outfit that I wore when I was baptized. Pastor Paul Anderson and Barb Auer at Servant of Christ Lutheran Church in Champlin, Minnesota, where I was confirmed, accompanied the children's choir, and was a member of the worship band Servant Song. We had just played on a parade float, and there's the arrow pointing at me. This is where I started to lead worship, and I really started to consider being a pastor. I was actually meeting with Pastor Paul about the possibility of pursuing that, but 17 years old, not ready. Yep, and that's the first time I don't remember what I said, but I think it was like a sermon. I don't know. And that is my grandparents, who were actually in the picture of when I was baptized too. So they followed my spiritual journey that whole way. Anoka Covenant Church in Anoka, Minnesota. Paula Erickson, Paul Berchi, and he was just the bass player at the time, but now he's a pastor, Andrew Sturdy. There I led worship with the band. My time there and the people really helped me with critical thinking about my own faith and what I profess to believe. It's one thing to say stuff, but then to actually sit there and dissect it and go, oh, not sure about that. Maybe, yep, that for sure. The people of Aldersgate United Methodist Church in St. Louis Park, Minnesota, where I led worship and played for concerts and on parade floats with the band Faith Alive. We played, I don't remember where the parade was, but they said that there was something like 35 to 40,000 people that would have been there from the beginning to the end. And that's interesting to think about that. And I am in the middle of a class about evangelism, so it's nice to make that connection. Paul Carey at Brooklyn Park Evangelical Free Church, where I was a member of the worship band Project One. Oh, that feels like so long ago. So they had this program on Wednesday evenings, and it was called Project One. And it would start off with, like, the church had that coffee shop, and they would do, like, fellowship with that in that area. And then they would have the time of worship, and then people would split off into small groups or Bible studies. It was just like this evening-long program that was really for, I don't know, high school age, middle school age, college age, young families. It really showed me the potential for Christian education and for raising up new leaders. The Wayzata Community Church, all the people there in Wayzata, Minnesota. Autumn Toussaint was the leader of the worship band there. The band's called Tapestry. I was told right away that is not a reference to the Carole King album, like I had thought, yeah. So there I led music, I was involved in music for worship and concerts. They encouraged me and they showed me new ways to worship with music. And coupled that with the critical thinking, now I look back at and have to analyze that style of music for worship. And I'm not sure how I feel about it. Pastor Eric Renner, Becky Chakotsky, and Amy Hewitt at Shepherd of the Prairie Moravian Church in Fargo. They showed me what it means to give abundant grace and kindness. Pastor Paula, George Lee, and Todd Wagner at Martin's Lutheran Church in Castleton, where I led worship with the band. This is their old sanctuary. They got a new building, but I never had anything to do with it, so that's the only sanctuary of theirs that I know. This is where I really started to get serious about the way I chose music for worship and what songs would fit better where, and maybe like pacing, stuff like that. Cody Schuler and the leadership team at the Gathering Church, where I led music for worship with the band. This is also where I met Pastor Mina Hall, who was here for a while. I was given an abundance of freedom to try new things with music for worship. I was shown the wealth of individual and congregational growth that can come from fellowship. Christopher Hansen, Jay Hohertz, Pastor Martin Avery, and Pastor Ray Baker at Faith United Methodist Church, where I was a member of the Big House Band. Christopher showed me this potential for a church musician to move beyond that position of just playing or just being the one who chooses the music into something that's bigger, that has more responsibilities and really more ways to serve the church. And that brought me here to Flame of Faith United Methodist Church in West Fargo, where I began as a worship leader and a musician, became the administrative assistant, and eventually began my seminary education with the guidance of my boss, my pastor, my mentor, my colleague in ministry, and my friend, Pastor Sara McManus. I've had the privilege of leading music for worship with my son and watching him grow into an amazing young man with a strong faith. And I'm surprised, but I've been able to speak to you up here many, many times. So it's an honor to speak to you from up here. God's guidance leads us to more deeply discerning our divine direction. Study builds confidence in this practice of leaning our ears to hear God's voice. And all this empowers us to live into our calling as people of God, as servants of Christ, as workers to bring forth the kingdom. Please pray with me. Almighty God, you brought us together today, whether in person or online. Let this community of faith serve as a network of your guidance. Work in us and through us. Bring us wisdom through study. Empower us as we seek to build your kingdom. In the name of Christ Jesus, we pray. Amen. Our closing song is My Heart Will Trust in You. And if you want to stand, that would be awesome. I just have to walk over there, so take your time.
By the water still my soul,
My heart will trust in you. My heart will trust in you. Though I walk through valleys low, I'll fear no evil. By the waters still my soul, my heart will trust in you. Though I walk through valleys low, I'll fear no evil. By the waters still my soul, my heart will trust in you. My heart will trust in you.
Please stand as you're able and hear this evening's benediction. As we leave this place, may the power of the Holy Spirit guide us as we work to transform lives in the whole world. Amen.